This is the largest, most complex, and challenging space telescope ever constructed. It will change our understanding of the universe and our place in it.
Hey everyone, I'm Rebecca and welcome to Watch Mojo. Today we're counting down our picks for the top 10 upcoming space missions.
Perseverance is a very, very profound first step in both our understanding of our place in the universe and a stepping stone towards human exploration on Mars.
Dragonfly will be the first drone lander with the capability to fly over 100 miles through Titan's thick atmosphere.
The rover's instruments will examine the atmosphere, and there's also a drill that can bore down to 2 meters deep.
For this list, we're looking at the most exciting missions yet to launch, as well as missions that have launched but haven't reached their destinations. Let us know in the comments which ones you're most excited for. All right, let's get to it.
Number 10, the SpaceX Crewed Flight to Mars. All eyes are on Mars, and arguably the most ambitious future Martian of all is Elon Musk.
What I really want to try to achieve here is to make Mars seem possible, make it seem as though it's something that we can do in our lifetimes.
Though he initially had the lofty aim of sending the first unmanned mission in 2022 and a crewed mission in 2024, those dates have been pushed back. The unmanned mission is now slated for 2024 and the first humans in 2027.
Yeah, the long-term aspiration is to develop the technologies necessary to transport a large number of people and cargo to Mars in order to create a self-sustaining civilization there. And that's really why I started the company.
This, of course, depends on the completion of the SpaceX Starship, the vehicle designed to take humans to the Red Planet. It's an ambitious timeline, and the dates are not set in stone, or else this would rank higher up on our list. It could mark just the beginning of our presence on Mars. Musk hopes we'll have a city there by 2050. Number 9, the Perseverance rover. In July 2020, NASA launched the most advanced Mars rover to date, Perseverance, or Percy to the people at NASA's Jet Propulsion Laboratory.
As the countdown to Mars continues, the Perseverance of humanity launching the next generation of robotic explorers to the Red Planet.
Perseverance still has a ways to go and won't be touching down in the Jezero Crater until February 2021.
Jezero Crater is a very interesting place. It's a crater that once held a lake.
There are a lot of craters on the surface of Mars that could have once hosted ancient lakes, but not every crater that we think had a lake actually preserves evidence that that lake was there.
The rover is also carrying a small autonomous helicopter, Ingenuity, to help scout the Martian landscape. This will hopefully help make things easier on future rovers. The mission will help experts answer a wide variety of questions, but there's one big one in mind. Are there any signs of life on Mars, past or present? Most excitingly, the samples that Perseverance collects could eventually make a return journey, although how they'll be transported back is still in development.
Perseverance is a very, very profound first step in both our understanding of our place in the universe and a stepping stone towards human exploration on Mars.
Number 8, Psyche. In 2022, the spacecraft Psyche will set off on a long journey towards one of the solar system's weirdest asteroids, named, somewhat confusingly, 16 Psyche.
16 Psyche is an asteroid that orbits the sun out between Mars and Jupiter.
It is the only asteroid that we're aware of that is 95% metal or more and is really huge. It's about 200 kilometers across in one axis.
This asteroid is worth investigating because it's believed by scientists to be the iron core of a protoplanet, an object that may currently be on its way to becoming a true planet.
Psyche gives us the opportunity to visit a core, the only way that humankind can ever do, and it would be the first metal object that humankind has ever visited.
The information Psyche collects will hopefully teach us lots about how planets form and how devastating asteroid collisions can be. If all goes to plan, Psyche will reach the asteroid belt by 2026, and its core mission will run for just shy of 2 years.
We can understand this universe that we live in. We can explore it, we can learn about it, and we can be a part of something which is much bigger than just us or just this planet. We will see new things when we visit a world made of metal.
Number 7, the ExoMars rover. Originally slated to launch in July of 2020, ExoMars is a rover built for a joint mission between Russia's Roscosmos and the European Space Agency.
The orbiter is sniffing the Martian atmosphere for gases like methane that might be linked to biological or geological activity.
It's now set to launch sometime in 2022 and is officially named Rosalind Franklin, after an English chemist. Roscosmos is building both the launcher and the lander.
The rover's instruments will examine the atmosphere, and there's also a drill that can bore down to 2 meters deep.
The rover is heading to Oxyoplanum, a large plain full of clay deposits.
We want to account for any adverse situation, for example, landing on the foot of a small hill, which have our lander tilted, or landing when our ramps open, we have an obstacle on one of them, or one of the other ramp lands on an obstacle, so you have to egress in a tilted configuration.
There, it will search for signs of past Martian life.
If it found something, what would it look like?
I think it's unlikely to be sort of little green men at this stage. It's probably going to be bacteria, because we tend to find that in the most arid locations on Earth. It's the most hardy form of life we know.
The ExoMars mission has been ongoing since 2016, when the Trace Gas Orbiter was launched. And hopefully, Rosalind Franklin will launch on time. Number 6, Martian Moons Exploration. Though much of our interest in space exploration revolves around our moon and Mars, Mars actually has 2 moons of its own, Phobos and Deimos. They haven't gotten much attention to date, but a Japanese aerospace exploration agency mission set to launch in 2024 will change that. By August 2025, the Martian Moons Exploration Probe, or MMX, will have reached and landed on Phobos. It will also perform flybys of Deimos, the smaller moon, before its mission ends and the probe returns with samples to Earth. It's aiming to find out how Mars's moons were formed. Other space agencies, including NASA, are designing additional equipment for the probe. Number 5, China's Large Modular Space Station. The China National Space Administration has ambitious plans to launch an operational space station in 2022. It will be China's third after Tiangong 1 and 2. The intention is that, unlike its two predecessors, this space station will be permanent.
The elegant design and appearance reflects how advanced it is, and reflects the development of China's space engineering over the past decade.
The CNSA will use the Long March 5B rocket to launch the necessary materials into orbit. Though construction has seen a few delays, the core module is set for launch in 2021.
Presumably, you want it to be the best.
Of course. I hope our space program will be better and better.
It's thought that the space station will be able to aid future manned moon missions for China, who already made lunar history when Chang'e 4 became the first spacecraft to soft land on the far side of the moon in 2019. China is also set to become the third country to bring back samples from the moon when Chang'e 5 returns in mid-December 2020. Number 4, Jupiter Icy Moons Explorer, or JUICE. There's a lot to be learned from Jupiter's largest moons. Planned for 2022, the European Space Agency's JUICE mission will launch for a closer look.
The ESA's mission, JUICE, will provide the most comprehensive exploration of this giant planet and, in particular, of its moons, supposedly hiding habitable zones under their icy crusts.
The Jupiter Icy Moons Explorer, or JUICE, will take 7 years to reach its destination, arriving at the Jovian system in late 2029. It's going to do flybys of Callisto, Europa, and Ganymede, all of which may host subsurface oceans and have the potential for alien life.
The only thing that remains for us to find is how this water, how deep is it, how far is it from the surface, what is its extent, and if there could be life, living organisms originating in the liquid water within the underneath oceans on these icy moons.
This mission will last until 2032, when JUICE will end up orbiting Ganymede, becoming the first man-made probe to orbit an alien moon.
This space mission requires years of patient work in dealing with the limits of our technology, which will be nearly out of date when the space probe begins sending back its first data. It'll be like receiving a call from the future.
When it runs out of fuel, estimated to be around 2034, it will crash into the surface. Number 3, Dragonfly. One of the most promising bodies in the solar system for supporting life is Saturn's largest moon, Titan.
Dragonfly will be the first drone lander with the capability to fly over 100 miles through Titan's thick atmosphere. Titan is unlike any other place in our solar system and the most comparable to early Earth.
To date, however, we've been working with very limited knowledge based on the findings of a handful of missions. In 2027, NASA is looking to launch the Dragonfly spacecraft, a robotic rotorcraft that will explore Titan's surface.
At each new landing site on Titan's surface, Dragonfly uses a pulsed neutron generator and onboard gamma ray sensor to detect key elements such as carbon and hydrogen in organic materials.
Dragonfly should finally be able to tell us whether Titan might be able to support human life, or even alien life, more effectively than the inner planets.
The instruments on board will help us investigate organic chemistry, evaluate habitability, and search for chemical signatures of past or even present life.
But even if it all goes to plan, it's still not going to arrive at Titan until 2036. So we've got a long wait ahead. Number 2, the James Webb Telescope launch. A mission that's likely to yield results much sooner, the James Webb Space Telescope is NASA's replacement for the Hubble Space Telescope.
This is the largest, most complex, and challenging space telescope ever constructed. It will change our understanding of the universe and our place in it.
The latter has made innumerable contributions to our knowledge of outer space, but technology has come a long way 30 years later. Unfortunately, the James Webb Telescope has been plagued by delays and has seen its original budget multiplied many times over.
Webb is a technological challenge like no other, born of the efforts of thousands of people across the United States, Canada, and Europe.
Be that as it may, it's finally set to launch October 2021. The telescope will function in a much wider spectrum of light than Hubble, largely focusing on infrared. This means it'll be able to capture low-light stars like red dwarf stars and observe entire galaxies previously hidden from view.
The Webb Telescope is designed to look back to a time when stars and galaxies were first forming, over 13.5 billion years ago. With its revolutionary design and capabilities, the Webb Telescope is about to unleash a new dawn of discovery.
So how many of these had you already heard about? Well, we've got one more, and it's our number one, so it is bound to be super exciting. So let's get through some honorable mentions, and then we'll name our top upcoming space mission.
The Parker Solar Probe. In 2025, it will make its closest approach to the sun.
It will fly to within 4 million miles of the sun's surface, confronting brutal radiation and temperatures that can reach 1 million degrees Fahrenheit.
ESRO's first manned mission. In 2022, India will send its astronauts into space for the first time.
Actually, it is not the simply sending man into the space. That is not the criteria. One thing is to do this thing. Very, very lot of benefits we'll get out of that.
The Dear Moon Project. In 2023, Japanese billionaire Yusaku Maezawa hopes to fly around the moon.
The crew will spend a week in space. What will they feel when they see the moon? When they see Earth in full view? And what will they create?
Before we continue, be sure to subscribe to our channel and ring the bell to get notified about our latest videos. You have the option to be notified for occasional videos or all of them. If you're on your phone, make sure you go into your settings and switch on notifications. Number 1, the Artemis missions.
We are returning to the moon.
As a new generation of explorers, this time to stay.
1972 was the last time humans walked on the moon, after which point the Apollo program was abandoned. But NASA is looking to head back in the 2020s, launching the Artemis program that will aim to put more astronauts on the moon by 2024, including the first woman.
This all starts with the ability to get larger, heavier payloads off planet and beyond Earth's gravity.
Though not necessarily part of the Artemis program, NASA is also planning to build the Lunar Gateway, a space station in lunar orbit, the construction of which will also begin in 2024. It might not be useful to the first Artemis astronauts, but it's sure to be an invaluable tool for lunar exploration in the late 2020s, 2030s, and beyond.
To accomplish the task of launching our crew and heavy payloads, NASA is building the Space Launch System, comprising of a cargo hold, an exploration upper stage, a massive core stage, and two extended solid rocket boosters. Altogether, this is the world's most powerful rocket.
Both Artemis and the Gateway also involve global cooperation from other leading space agencies. biographies.
It's all pretty exciting stuff. But what is it in space that you're most excited to learn more about? Be sure to let us know in the comments, or come tell me on Twitter or Instagram at Rebecca Brayton, or on my YouTube channel. See ya!